Welcome aboard to Trump University's Triumph with Tax Liens course. We've been working around the clock to bring you the very latest advances in what many consider to be the most opportunity-packed real estate market of a lifetime. Remember, the key to success is not merely to learn, but to apply that knowledge in the endless world of opportunity. And no one is in a better position to help you succeed than Trump University's professional real estate coach, handpicked for you by Donald Trump. Let me encourage you to dive into your materials and call your coach today. Congratulations and good luck.
Trump University has put this together for the student base, those of you that were on the call, and I want to congratulate you for taking this step of action. Today, the reason why Trump University has put this together is to lay out all of the information, and let me just say this as we begin, is that the information itself is not overly exciting. But what is exciting is what this information can do for your families, all right, in terms of getting tremendous rates of return. When I say return, I mean interest return, and at the same time having it be very safe. All right, so here we go. Let's get right into this. All right, so the first thing in any kind of education is that you need to know the vocabulary. You know, doctors have a particular vocabulary, MDs, lawyers have a particular vocabulary. And these are some of the terms and words and initials that you'll see in the tax lien business or the tax lien industry, right? And so having said all this, is that what we're going to become is tax lien investors. So we have the term tax lien certificate. You'll see that written out that way, TLC, which is a tax lien certificate. In real estate, you'll see another term, LTV, which is loan to value. These are some of the different things that you'll see. Broker, when we say broker, typically we're talking about a real estate broker, but also sometimes there are financial instrument brokers, someone that has a Series 7 license, et cetera, that sort of thing. Due diligence. It's very important that we do our due diligence, especially when we're talking about buying financial instruments, and these financial instruments will be backed by a piece of valuable real estate. But we have to do that due diligence, and we'll be talking about some of those things. All right. So now we're up to public records. Public records is where the actual information on the tax liens are stored in the public records, and there are different offices. It could be the Treasury office, it'll be at the county level or at the municipal level. We'll get into where those things are later, but public records, that's where this information is. That's when a legal action has taken place, and then something is filed with a particular county, whether it's in the courthouse or with a tax court, et cetera, and it becomes part of public record. So this information is public record. Interest rate. We all know what an interest rate is, and unfortunately, they've been pretty low lately on just regular investments. Redemption period. That's the you'll see that come up. And the redemption period is the time that a taxpayer that is delinquent has to actually bring their taxes up to date. Okay, so. And so they have a period, it could be 6 months, it could be 1 year, and anytime within that redemption period, a particular taxpayer that is delinquent can indeed pay their taxes off, and that's what the redemption period is. So we have subsequents, we have special deeds, we've got bid backs. These are things that you're going to see as we go through, bid offs, discount sale, interest bid down. And we'll go through a lot of these things and take them on the basis of explaining them to you so you know what to look for. But here's the thing. What you really need to know in all this, and this is very important, is that there has to be a financial instrument that you're going to buy. And then when you buy that financial instrument, you're going to want to know the value of the real estate that's behind it. We've got interest bid down, rotational sale. These are the types of auctions that take place at the tax sales, premium and overbid sale, random selection. This all has to do with the auction process. And again, some of you may choose to actually buy the properties at auction, and you may choose to buy the properties after they've been at auction and buy them at home on the internet using the over-the-counter method or the leftover method, and we'll go over that. And that's a wonderful way of buying the properties as well. Bid down the ownership. That's also in the bidding process. That's one of my least favorite ones. Over-the-counter sale, that's where the leftovers are. That's otherwise known as OTC. Tax deeds, that's when you're actually getting the deed to the property as opposed to a certificate, which does not represent ownership of the property. The deed itself does. And then struck, that would be struck off. Those are properties that that were delinquent, and then over a period of time, it was found that there is that the owners have either passed away or gone on. Nobody can find them, and those will be struck off, and that they will be owned by the counties or the municipalities. So this is a beginning process on the vocabulary. All right. So and let's go. So you know the tax lien basics. Is that, you know, a tax lien has a legal hold on the property. It's issued by the municipality when the property owner hasn't paid their property taxes. This is something that's very important, or that you understand that the that's what the lien is. It means that somebody has not paid their taxes, and then the certificate it turns into a tax lien certificate when the county actually turns this from a delinquency into a financial instrument, right? And so then once the tax lien is sold, the buyer receives a certificate of purchase. So this is the actual piece of paper that represents that tax lien. You're not actually going to the courthouse to pay anybody's taxes. What you're doing is you're buying an investment certificate. And that's what the tax lien certificate is, a TLC. Is straight up is the abbreviation of tax lien certificate, and then the deed. The deed is the actual title to the property. The tax lien certificate holders might actually claim the deed after the redemption period has expired. Now, you can claim something like that. You can wind up with the property. This is how you will wind up with getting properties for 10 and 15 and 20 cents on the dollar. It's and you'll actually have the deed to the property. Before the sale, what you're going to want to do is to do your due diligence, right? You've got to do the background research, and that's, you know, the research is up to you. The county, and this is very important, the county itself is not going to do the due diligence for you. You're responsible for that, right? So the county wants your money in terms of actually collecting the money on the unpaid taxes. The investor, that's you. The investor is going to provide liquidity to the county by buying those tax lien certificates. But it's up to you, the investor, to do the due diligence by using public records or by speaking to real estate brokers or what have you. And we'll go through this more in depth in some of the other lessons. But the responsibility is on the investor to actually understand what the value of the real estate is that the tax lien is on. So that's very important. So you have to know, all right, you have to find that lien. You have to analyze it, meaning you have to know what the property is worth. You have to control it, meaning you're going to have to actually buy the instrument, and then you have to figure out what your execution strategy is going to be. But you have to do that, the research, where you have to pay somebody to do it. And we have different ways of discussing how to do the research later on in the sessions. But just understand this. If you just run into a county and you want to buy a lien, they'll sell you a tax lien. But it is up to you, the investor, to know how much the property is worth that the tax lien is on. Some people think that they're buying something that's a good deal just because the lien is a small amount. Not necessarily so. The lien can be a small amount, but you want to make sure that that lien is on a valuable piece of real estate as opposed to some piece of junk land. And it's the county's responsibility to collect the money from you and then they will collect the tax from the taxpayer, and then they will in turn pay you. That's how you get your interest. But more on that later. So these are the beginning slides of this. Now, when you see loan to value, that's the difference between the amount of mortgage on a home and its fair market value. You've seen that before. Those of you that are homeowners or even business owners or have been involved in the real estate business, you know that's a formula. Sometimes it's a bank will lend 80% loan to value. Sometimes they'll lend 75% loan to value, that sort of thing. Right now, the banks are anywhere between 70% loan to value, 65% loan to value. It's not as freewheeling. When we talk about hard money, maybe in the at the end of the six sessions here with this, and you may want to use some hard money loans in order to secure some of your investments, because you'll be able to actually get a very good return even with using hard money. Hard money is opportunity money. And then, of course, a broker. A broker is somebody who organizes a deal between the buyer and the seller. People sometimes attend a tax lien sale on behalf of other parties. This is called proxy when they do that. So you don't need to be dealing with a broker when you buy a tax lien. This is something that you can do on your own. Some people use a broker or a proxy. They'll go to and actually bid for them at the sale. Proxy is somebody who, quote unquote, will do their bidding for you. When you analyze the investment, or you want to look at what the interest rate is, and this is very important, and we get into this in other sections, you need to know this: how much your budget is for buying liens. I don't know if you have $1,000 to invest. Well, that you can do this business. Or if you have $500 to invest, you can do this business. Even if you have $100 and you buy a $100 lien, you can do this. Listen, when we're talking about interest rates of 12 or 24%, 16%, 10%, these are substantial interests. And, you know, it's better to get 24% on $100 than it is to take that $100 and go out and, you know, buy a couple of Starbucks coffees and, you know, whatever. You can start this business with as little or as much as you like. And the thing is that it's very, very safe, right? So that's the interest rate. And so you're really going to look at an opportunity. You're not going to work geography unless you need to have a piece of property in a specific geography, unless you need to have a piece of property in Oregon or a piece of property in Texas or a piece of property in New York. You don't necessarily need to look in those places. You need to look where the interest rate is the most favorable to you. That's what you're after, is interest first and then property second. You know, that's the way to look at this, because the worst that you're going to do is get all of your money back with interest, right? And the best you're going to do is you're going to wind up getting a piece of real estate for 10 or 15 cents on the dollar. Now, the redemption period is the amount of time that the taxpayer has in order to pay their tax bill. So this redemption period is something that you as the investor have to wait for. You've got to wait out this redemption period. So if it's a one-year redemption period, you won't get your money back, okay, for a year unless somebody redeems before the redemption period. And a taxpayer might redeem the taxes before the redemption period, but they also might not. But certainly, by the redemption period, when that's redeemed, that's when you get all of your money back, meaning the principal that you put in to this, which is what you paid for that particular tax lien, and that's also then when you get your interest rate, and that's upon the redemption period. So the investment itself is not liquid at this time, okay, until the redemption period is satisfied. Once the redemption period is satisfied, if it's a six-month redemption period, you get all your money back in 6 months. If it's a one-year redemption period, you get all of your money back within 1 year. So that's it. It won't go over the redemption period. It's within the redemption period. Let's go to the let's go take a look at the next slide, right? And this is just some of the different types of bidding. And we'll go through this more later on, but this is a bid down the interest. This is where the state starts at a maximum rate of return, right? So as an example, so let's say we start in a place like Florida that has an 18% rate of return, an interest rate. And then this is at the auction. This bid down scenario is at the auction itself. So if it starts at 18%, the auctioneer or the tax collector or somebody that the tax collector has hired to do the sale starts at 18%. And they would say, all right, 18%, would anybody give me 18%? So with any luck, if everybody's there, they're going to be raising their hands at 18% that, for the county, then they'll say 17%. Well, maybe a lot of hands go down because they only wanted 17%. And then the next, if all hands are still up, then they'll go to 16% and then 15%. And this can go all the way down to zero, actually. And then what will happen is that there will be a premium bid on top of the overage. We'll talk about that later. But so here's the thing. The interest would start at 18%, but if you did this, and that's bidding competitively at the auction, but you actually may want to just buy this over the counter or as a leftover, and then you won't have to worry about going to the auction or doing any of the bidding. You just get the straight 18%. But that's how it's done at the auction, and we'll talk about this a little more. And then, of course, there's random and rotational bidding as well. And these are all, when you see random and rotational and bid down the interest, these are all different ways that a county will administer an auction. And then this is bid down the ownership. And this is an example. I'll read this and I'll tell you what it means. It says, the investor is willing to purchase the lien for the lowest percent of encumbrance on the property, and that will be awarded the lien. Okay. For example, a bidder may agree to take a lien on only 95% of the property. If the lien is redeemed, the investor only receives 95% of the proceeds. Most investors will not accept less than the full encumbrance, so with multiple owners,